Deep within the Sierra Madres of Mexico lives a people group known as the Tarahumara Indians. In their native language, Tarahumara means, literally, light-footed ones. This indigenous group is renowned for their ability to run great distances over very harsh and rugged terrain. The typical race covers more than 300 miles in 2 days through canyons and over mountains. Contestants endure the oppressive heat of the day and continue running throughout the night. When the sun begins its descent and darkness engulfs the course, members of the tribe will carry torches and run alongside their friend to light their path and encourage them to press on. These super athletes are not clad in the latest gear from Nike or Adidas. Rather, the Tarahumara run barefoot or in primitive sandals made from leather or old tires. There are no corporate sponsors or promises of lucrative endorsement deals. When it comes to ultra-distance running, nothing can beat a Tarahumara runner. Not a cheetah, not a racehorse, nor even an Olympic marathon runner. They run because they were born to run. Their prize is to simply finish the race and to finish it well. The Tarahumara are a people who have not changed with time. Their existence is primitive at best. Their homes are in caves or under the overhangs of a cliff. Wealthier members might live in a simple shack. They plant meager crops by hand and harvest enough food to make it through the winter. When one lives under these conditions, there are no lofty dreams for the future. Survival is your only goal, and the next meal is an eternity away. The Tarahumara are running a much more serious race for survival. In recent studies by the Mexican government, it is estimated that there are only 50 to 70,000 Tarahumara left. Such low numbers are an early indicator that this tribe is facing extinction. In a study conducted by the World Bank, it was determined that 49% of Tarahumara are living below the poverty level as defined by the Mexican government. With all that they have going against them, they have also been victims of a severe drought that has lasted 12 years. Such conditions and extreme poverty foster an environment where women are seen as property and children exist to serve as free labor. They have been exploited by large corporations who stripped their lands of precious resources and paid no money for what would have been lucrative mineral rights. Today, they are threatened by a new kind of evil. Their isolation and primitive life make them prime targets for exploitation by the drug cartels. It was under these conditions that Jeff and Patty were contacted by government officials and asked if they could take a group of Tarahumara children. With a need so great and an orphanage that was ready for kids, the Grahams answered the call. They traveled deep into the heart of Chihuahua, into the isolated and desolate Sierra Madres, and what they found broke their hearts. One boy who was 6 at the time had been living under a park bench for 2 years before anyone helped him find a home. Another boy had already been used as a mule to haul drugs and was addicted to cocaine. He had completed rehab, but now had no place to go. A mother of a young girl asked that her daughter be placed in the orphanage for fear that her daughter's rapists would return to torment her. Another girl was found wandering around, alone in the middle of nowhere. Her mother was an alcoholic, passed out at home, oblivious to their daughter's whereabouts. One boy among the group had witnessed every member of his family gunned down and murdered by cartel hitmen. The rest of the children were found living in caves and ditches. If they were lucky, they might sleep in a shelter with goats and chickens. Uneducated, unloved, and orphaned, these kids needed a home. These kids were born to run the race and to go the distance, but their survival was on the line. Without someone helping to provide them with even the most basic of necessities such as food, shelter, and an education, how could any of them make it against such odds? Jeff and Patty knew at that moment their own personal race had been set before them. When they looked into the hungry faces and saw the empty looks of despair, they remembered the verse from Jeremiah 29:11. "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope." These kids were theirs, and they knew it from the moment they set eyes on them. What the enemy had set out to destroy, the Lord set out to prosper. Long before the Rescue a Child Orphanage was constructed, He knew their names, and He ensured a home would be built for them. Through His providence, their destinies now were aligned with that of Streams of Water Ministries. For 2 years, these boys and girls have lived in a real home. Their physical needs are met on a daily basis. Many of them had never known the tender touch of a parent, nor did they know how to connect emotionally with another human being. Today, they have house parents who care for them and connect with them emotionally. They have become a family and live as brothers and sisters. Their spiritual needs are met through the sound biblical teaching they receive daily. The walls and roof over their heads provide a sense of security that they never knew before. An environment has been created where they can be kids and play the games that little girls and boys play. The goal of Streams of Water Ministries is simple. They desire that each one of the kids who has been entrusted to them grows up knowing that his future is bright. These children are taught that with hard work and diligence, they can accomplish anything they set their mind to, and that the sky is the limit. They will be a voice for their generation, and they are the leaders of tomorrow. Perhaps some will return home as leaders to the Tarahumara people and help transform their culture. The world and even their families have abandoned them. They need their own torchbearers to light the path and to help them navigate the difficult course of life. Would you consider helping to light the way for these children? Streams of Water Ministries cannot do this alone. With your generous gifts and support as a torchbearer, these kids will have the resources they need to run their race of life and run it well.